Le Mans is very important in Mexico. We had Pedro Rodriguez win Le Mans about 40, 45 years ago. So there's a heritage, and I think people are excited and waiting to see the modern Le Mans cars in person.
What we have, me and Bruno and Ricardo, we don't have egos. We are having fun, we are working together to know, to help each other to be the best, the fastest.
The Mexican fans are quite interesting because they are here not only for the big names, but they are here for the spectacle. They're here for the cars. Last two times I came, they were all over everybody. And it's like they really want to meet the drivers. They are a lot of Senna fans here, which was really cool.
With the passion of Mexicans, that Latin blood, I think it's going to be very nice when we see the cars go by through here and the whole stadium standing and yelling.
Time the WEC has visited Mexico, and with a population of over 21.2 million, we're keen to bring the spirit of Le Mans to the people of Mexico City. And in return, they have certainly embraced the WEC with a special press conference hosted by the mayor at the town hall. That hospitality continued into the night with a welcome party held in the city, with many familiar faces enjoying themselves before they get serious out on track. At over 2,000 meters above sea level, it's expected to be a challenge for both man and machine. The World Endurance Championship has made it to Mexico, and just look at that grandstand all the way around me. It's expected to be a busy race weekend here, and it's also a busy track walk as all of the teams want to go and check out the new circuit on our calendar. So let's see what they think.
I race here many times. I've been on the podium, on the pole, but walking on the track, I can see that they change every single corner.
Okay.
Yes, but it's a nice track, a nice crowd, very passionate fans, and the altitude plays a big role on the performance of the car.
I feel pretty good right now. And I restart training quite hard, and it's everything all right. But after, you never know in a race car if it's fine or not, if the track is bumpy, if it's painful or not to get in and out.
So you haven't been in a car yet then?
Just in a simulator. It's not real, so we'll see in reality on the track what's going on.
And like you say, coming around this corner, this is quite an awesome sight, isn't it?
Oh yeah, I can imagine when it will be full, the thing will be very impressive. So yeah, hopefully we'll have a good race there for the spectator.
It's going to be amazing. Hopefully they'll be pretty full on Saturday. So, but yeah, this last part of the circuit, this stadium complex, we're just having a chat about turn sort of two into the stadium here, this left. It's on a crest and it's going to be quite awkward to see. So just need to find out a few references around the track. But yeah, it'll be amazing racing here on Saturday.
We'll be right back. long straights. We've got some high intense braking zones with some slow speed corners after it. But then we've also got in the middle of the track a really fast section.
We are so high in altitude, we have to add a lot of downforce because the density of the air is not as big.
The circuit here in Mexico is a bit more narrow than you expect for a big 6-hour race with 34 cars in the grid.
The track is shorter compared to the other racetrack. That means we're going to have probably much more traffic for LMP1 cars.
Clearly, we might have a little bit of trouble with the brakes temperature. We will look at putting as much downforce as we can on the car.
I think the traffic in Sector 3 will be a big issue. Mainly, we will be causing the traffic for the LMP1 and LMP2s, but traffic is always difficult though, I think.
Much more overtaking, much more opportunity to have problems and contact, so it's going to be different compared to other races, and a different challenge, definitely.
We have a historic stadium here. Going through the stadium for 6 hours with lots and lots of people watching us will be a special feeling.
It's race day, round 5 of the 2016 FIA World Endurance Championship. And the calendar has a brand new venue. Mexico City, and today all roads lead to the Autódromo Hermanos Rodríguez. Excellent local promotion, TV advertising has brought out the local fans in force. Always one of the most popular times of the weekend, the autograph session. Pit lane thrown open and the fans able to get very close to their heroes. And their heroes in a Mexican mood. Plenty of local interest with Mexican and South American drivers. And some superstars from the past, as Alan McNish was mingling in the crowd too. Brand new feature for the FIA World Endurance Championship, racing through a baseball stadium, and the drivers on open top buses getting as close as possible to as many of the fans as possible, and a great reception.
Yeah, I don't know where the next stop is, but I'm going where you're going. I think there'll be even more people in the next few hours because the race is still a little bit away, so listen to the noise already, they're getting pretty ballistic. It's really good to be here. They've made a big effort, and it's going to be a really awesome race.
It's awesome, and lovely teammates here. So it's very nice. It's cool to be here in Mexico. All those fans and stuff, people are really nice.
The race still a little while away, but entertainment on two wheels before we get to the action on four.
Thank you.
an extraordinary welcome to the FIA World Endurance Championship, and local media interest massive for this event. Adrian Fernandez raced at the highest level for 32 years, IndyCar, sports cars, and has been part of the organizing team with Ricardo Gonzalez.
I'm very proud to have a WEC here in Mexico. As you can see, Mexican fans are very knowledgeable about racing and they're very passionate, so very proud of them.
On the grid, the cars ready for competition. Pole position for the 98 Aston Martin Vantage V8, but put to the back of the grid after a ride height infringement from the Aston Martin team. But Aston Martin have first and second in GTE Pro, the 95 car on pole position.
Traffic is going to be the main thing, I'm sure. It's a short track with a lot of cars, and very tight corners, so it's keeping patient and stick out of trouble. That's going to be the main thing, I'm sure.
The first chapter of a potential fairy tale story has already been written with the 43 Ligier of the local team on pole position.
It's been crazy this weekend so far, a lot of Mexicans, and yesterday was just perfect to do the pole position, not only for us, but as well for the Mexicans to come over to see, especially the local hero Ricardo, to start from the pole position.
Toyota have had a tough week, had to rebuild one of their cars, and Anthony Davison isn't quite recovered enough to race after a testing accident. So the front two rows, it's Audi and Porsche battling again.
It's the final moments before the start of the race, and look what we've got at the front of the grid, a checkerboard between Porsche and Audi. Our teams have had to deal with altitude, traffic, and there's the potential of rain here in Mexico City. We've got the number two Porsche in the number two spot on the grid, and for the first time, the number eight Audi are taking their first ever pole in WEC. So how are they going to handle it? We'll soon find out.
Well, the number eight Audi is on pole position, but not by very much, and the top four were separated by fractions of a second.
It was a great reward for all the Audi team. They worked very hard at home to bring a different spec of car, because here in the altitude, the car changes a lot, the cooling of the brakes, cooling of the engine, the turbo, this and that. So they did a lot of work, and the pole by so little margin was a reward for them also.
CEO of presenting sponsor AT&T and the president of the ACO Pierre Fillon honouring the Rodriguez brothers, legends of the sport. The formalities are over. It's time to focus on the race. We'll be right back.
flag for the start of the formation lap of the 6 hours of Mexico.
Cars are on the formation lap. Here's how they'll start. Audi 1 and 3, Porsche 2 and 4, and row 3, all Toyota Gazoo Racing. The locals in pole position for LMP2, Bruno Senna, will start. In 14th, the 41 of Greaves Motorsport, carrying the Mexican flag colours. Aston Martin, positions 1 and 2 in GTE Pro. And in GTE Am, it's the Porsche promoted to pole position. Six hours on the clock. It's time to go racing in Mexico City. The lights are green and the Audis streak away. Line astern down the long run towards the first corner. Bit of contact there, was there? Certainly thought so in the Porsche pit. But look at the CLM with the yellow wing coming through. The two privateers are very quick indeed. Audi's 1 and 2, Porsche 3 and 4. The pole man's gone wide. Luca de Grassi just went a little bit wide and his teammate's gone through. Now he's going to come under pressure by the world champion car. That's Brendan Hartley in the number one. There is the pole sitter going wide. Brendan has a little look. But look at the number four. The CLM by Collis and the Rebellion. Super quick in a straight line. Battle for second position then. Coming down to the Lake Esses. Brendan Hartley, the New Zealander, loving this track and trying to get between the two Audis, but it's still 1 and 2 for them at the moment. Spin for the 66-4, that's coming out the final corner. Oh, he got help there by the 51 AF Corsa Ferrari. GTE Pro, second place. Aston versus the 77 Porsche. Richie Stanaway in the Aston. And the Dempsey Proton racing car coming up behind. Bruno Senna has cleared off in LMP2. This is the battle for second. Championship leader, the 36, Gustavo Menezes, with behind him Rennie Rast. First time the 26 car hasn't started on pole position. It's the orange car there, and Johnny Kane right up behind them. There he is, and that's his view. He's our cameraman at about 180 miles an hour there into the stadium section. Oh, too wide! Nice piece of driving, and Rennie Rast goes to second position for G-Drive. The front straight here is almost a kilometre and a half long, and the two Audi teammates just battling it out for the lead. And we're back where we started, the Pullman back in front. Here's the view from Andre Lotterer's car. A couple of bits of contact to look at here on replay as Collard spun round by Pedro Lamy in the Aston Martin. And Richard Bradley, well, he'll not be sending Nick Manassian a Christmas card this year as the manor goes around.
It was quite a frustrating stint because we started on our qualifying tyres, which we used, and everybody else was new. So at the beginning, we weren't strong as we expected, but then the race started to come to us. Then we had an incident with Manassian, which I think was definitely a bit more on the other driver's fault than the Durrani incident, and that put me into the wall. Then we started to come back and everything was fine, and then the stint ended.
The stadium section, very popular with the fans. This is turn 13 and there's traffic for this battle for second place overall. A couple of GTs and an LMP2 car. This is going to be interesting. Brendan Hartley trying to make an advantage of this in the Porsche. Here he comes up the inside, gets a good run out of the Para Altada. A fantastic corner that still is. Oh, he's got the draft, he's got the power, he's got the speed, and he's got second position. Had to put two Michelins on the grass, but the outbreaking manoeuvre surely will put him into second place. It does. Lovely stuff by the New Zealander. Not much that Andre Lotterer in the 7 Audi could do about that, but he's still going to be a bit unhappy, I think. Great battles, not just at the lead of classes. This is sixth on down for LMP2. The red, white and blue car, Nick Manassian, then Pipo Durrani, then Panciatici. Pipo in that green and black car trying to get a little better exit than Manassian. He does. Oh, great move. On board with Bruno Senna. Oh, he's got a problem. He's slowing down. No, he's not. That's just how quickly Toyota went by him. There's an Aston Martin there as well. They've been super quick in a straight line. I might have panicked all the local supporters there, but Bruno Senna still leads in LMP2. Oh, Andrea Lotterer in the stadium section. And if you just look a little further ahead, you might be able to see the Porsche. Oh, but it's behind that he needs to be worried about now. Comes to the pit lane. That looked like a late decision, and this is an early stop. Expected him out there for at least another 10 laps or so. Well, the driver's not getting out, but there's a new set of Michelin tyres there. And now hearing from the team that Andre not happy with that first set of tyres. He was losing grip. He's not showing any emotion, though, is he? Lucas Degrassi in the number 8 Audi comes into the stadium section. Great place to watch motor racing, this. Not the fastest part of the circuit, but you really see the cars working and plenty of traffic as well. And we're about to see over 1,000 horsepower from the Audi. Gets rid of the Ferrari as if it wasn't there. Now the Ford GT, that's a very fast car, and it's gone. That's Victor Scheidtar, and he's just coming into the stadium section. He's hit the wall further back, maybe coming out of 11. Bits of carbon fibre bodywork all over the place. It's not too far from the pits. I'm not sure he'll even get it there, though. Oh, that's good driving, Victor. He's not going to spoil anyone else's race.
Full course yellow. We are under full course yellow.
So the debris needs to be taken away from a fast part of the circuit. And this is the opportunity for those that haven't stopped to come into the pit lane. This is terrible news for the number 7 Audi, who made their pit stop under green. They're going to lose out massively. Mark Leib out of the number 2. That was Neil Yarny getting in, and that is unmistakably Mark Webber in the number 1 car. Toyota taking the opportunity to come in as well, with both their cars 6 in first. And we're back to green racing. Everyone back on the throttle, and a very good restart indeed by Mark Webber. He was on it immediately there. He's put a lot of cars between himself and the number 2 Porsche. Nice move. Now, as Mark continues through the stadium section now, let's go down the pit lane. Louise Beckett is talking to his teammate Brendan Hartley.
Looks like it's a big fight. I passed Lotterer. I don't know if they had a problem after. I see he's dropped off. And I think I was coming back slowly to Degrassi. I was watching the time, so I think just before the full course yellow, there was about 7 seconds. So, yeah, very much all to play for. I think it's a similar story to Nürburgring. It's very, very tight. Whoever can put a very clean race together is going to end up on top.
For the tyres after step stage, very good. Tyres are very good at the end of the step stage. Keep pushing, keep pushing.
It's Kaz Nakajima in the number 5 red, white and black Toyota Gazoo racing machine coming out of the Para Altada. Behind him is the number 2. That's the Porsche of Neil Yarny, who's got a good run. Uses the power and the energy release of the Porsche. Side by side, 300 plus kilometres an hour. Down into the Mulsa Solana S's, the first set of corners. And the Porsche goes through. Expect to see Neil clearing off a little bit now. Oh, I'm not sure about that, actually. Kaz Nakajima has stayed pretty close, coming down the straight towards the Lake S's. But you can't get round the outside there. There simply isn't room, but there is. Nakajima has pulled that one off. That's an extraordinary manoeuvre. And he takes his third place back. Lent it to Neil Yarny for a while. Well, we saw this last lap, didn't we? And Neil Yarny has done it again, being able to pull past and go back up into that third position. Well, if anything, Nakajima is even a little bit closer this time. Can he pull the same outside move? Slightly downhill here. He's looking to do it, isn't he? He is going to do it. That's great stuff. And he goes back into third position. Oh, he's gone wide. Oh, brilliant stuff from these two. This is top entertainment. So what's happened here? This is into turn 12. Mike Conway going past the ESM number... Mike! A hip check into the wall. All right in ice hockey, not so much here. The marshals have been brilliant here in Mexico, and someone's got a nice souvenir for his man cave. 31 in to make sure there's no further damage other than that dive plane. Not a great week for the AF Corsa Ferraris. The 488 turbo cars sound very different to the 458. Oh, in fact, let's have a listen now. This is Jimmy Bruni looking back at his teammate. Altitude not helping the LMP2s either. Look how difficult it is to get past. Well, this is not a planned stop for the number five Toyota Kaz Nakajima in the pit lane, and it's not trivial either. It's going back into the garage. Now, this we were expecting. This is Mike Conway. Remember, he hit the ESM car a little bit earlier on. He's got a drive-through for that. And that will cost him somewhere in the region of 25, 26 seconds in time. Now, this is the Audi back in again, the 7 car, starting the next sequence of pit stops. Remember, he pitted early on the first stop. Let in, Lotterer out, talking to Luis.
The start was okay, it was good at the beginning, but then suddenly I had a massive performance drop. So we decided to change the tires early, and then it was much better. So my second stint was okay, no problems. So we have to understand what happened. Really strange and a bit of a shame, because made us pit earlier, and then they saved, the full course yellow arrived. We lost a lot of time, but still a long race.
Oh, that's Paul Dallolana and the 98 Aston Martin in the wall. Now, where's that? That's coming into the stadium, isn't it? And he's got reverse. Let's have a look and see what happens. That is Olivier Pla, who's been in the 66 Ford since the start. Ooh, that was a bit naughty as well. Well, good news for Aston Martin and for Paul Dallolana. He's got it going. A bit of bodywork damage there to the left-hand side. This is the battle for the lead, coming through traffic, down towards the first corner. Mark Webber, oh, tries to intimidate Degrassi there. But Degrassi's having none of it. Thought he was going to throw it up the inside there. Getting ready for pit stops here. But at the moment, this battle is raging on the far side of the circuit. Porsche from the two Audis. No, Audi from Porsche from Audi. New leader here in Mexico. Just less than 2 hours completed. And it's on. Let's take another look at that. Big sideways slide at the first corner. LMP2 leaders catching traffic. Oh, look, he's gone through. Gonzalez has gone through. On Rusinov. Oh, there's a touch. Gonzalez goes around. Oh, that's going to be a tough one to call. Gonzalez losing time in the local favourite 43 car. Well, Ricardo, where's reverse? Stay calm, stay calm. No, not that. That wasn't calm.
I was really pushing hard, especially the traffic. And then in my last lap before my pit, we arrived on two P2 cars, and he tried to be really aggressive. I have nothing to lose because I have to go to the pit. So okay, I let him pass. And then, you know, I don't know. And then he bones me, and we get a small touch. But I have nothing to do. I can't do anything. So sorry for him and sorry for me.
So Gonzalez into the pit lane. He's just given up second position as Gustavo Menezes has gone through. Don't think Bruno Senna was very happy there. Fourth place battle in LMP2. Stefan Riquelme does go through. On Maurizio Mediani in the 35 backseat DC Alpine. DC being David Cheng, whose team it is, that 35 car. New fourth position then for SMP Racing. Kaz Nakajima brought the number five in earlier on. I don't think it's good news. Down at Toyota, Luis is with Rob Leupen.
Well, car number five is retired. We have a problem, electric problem on the powertrain, and no chance to repair.
Relatively short circuit here at Mexico means that traffic management is always going to be an issue. Looking back from the 97 Aston Martin, we've got the championship leading 36 in LMP2 and Timo Bernhard in the number one Porsche. Let's have a listen.
I tried to save the rear tire a bit. Not a little bit loose rear, but all fine. I tried to save the rear bit.
And Timo Bernhard just trying to manage the gap from him in the leading car back to Loic de Val in that number eight Audi. He's doing a pretty decent job, hovering around 7 to 8 seconds. That's the 7 in the pit lane, and it's going slowly. That is not at 60 kilometres an hour, nowhere near it. I can't hear an engine. The engine's cut out. Oh, they've run out of fuel. I think they've run out of fuel. and it's going to be mechanic power, not hybrid or diesel, that gets that car to the pits. Well, that is really pushing the envelope from Audi. That's just how competitive it is. Let's have a listen.
Did you hear about the fuel? Inlet button and boxes nap. Full push inlet.
So reporting on the radio, and then engines cut out. Ran it out of fuel. Across the start line, the battle for GTAM second position. Yamagishi in the Corvette. Oh, here's Eduardo.
Be advised, track has been declared wet. All cars must have the rain lights on.
Well, I'll explain that in a moment, because Aguash is coming through to take second position, use the draft from the P2 car nicely. Now, obviously, the track isn't soaking wet, but that means the teams can use whatever tyres they want from now on in the race. GTAM leader into the pits, Abu Dhabi Proton Racing Porsche. Routine stop here. More debris on the track. And that might, well, it has. It's brought out a full course yellow. No overtaking. Hold position. And if you need service, this is a great time to do it. Both the Porsches are in. Lose less time because everyone's moving slower on the circuit. Big advantage if you can get in and out of the pits whilst the race is neutralised like this. Just on half of the race to go, Porsche lead Audi from Porsche and Toyota in fourth position for the moment. Championship leader Signatec Alpine leading the LMP2 class, and Aston Martin Racing have bossed GTE Pro 95 from 97. In the AM, it's Abu Dhabi Proton Racing Porsche from the 83 Ferrari, and then another Porsche, the 78, in third.
Well, if we just take a moment away from the action on track, there's plenty of entertainment for the WEC fans to take part in when they're here as spectators.
Realmente muy contento, con una gran ilusión de que la categoría WEC haya venido a México, a este espectacular autódromo de Hermanos Rodríguez, y cómo no, venir a apoyar al equipo Ford a la victoria en la categoría GT Pro.
Impresionante la organización que han hecho, y de los mejores eventos y las mejores carreras que yo he visto.
¡Viva México!
Very odd incident as Timo Bernard came to the pit lane, then changed his mind. There's been a penalty here. Here's Mark Webber to explain.
Yeah, it looks like a miscommunication, but we would like to at least go on to have a talk about it, at least, because we've had driver's briefings in the past that it's a concrete wall from, the white line is a concrete wall from track to pit entry, but if you come back from the other side, it's not, so still a bit of ambiguity on that rule, I think, but in the end, we'll drink the medicine now and keep fighting.
Stefan Riquelme has really taken the transition to sports cars from single seaters very, very well indeed. I think he's got a great future. Just getting lapped there by the Porsche, but that blue Alpine is leading its class, LMP2. Here's the GTE Pro leader, still the 95, as it has been pretty much since the start of the race, except for the pit stops. Nicky Team back in the car now. His teammate Richie Stanaway behind him, but 9 seconds or so behind him. Oh, this is an odd one. Oh, the Para Altada has claimed a victim. Just a brush of the wall by the AF Corsa number 83, battling for second and third position with Wolf Hensler in the blue and white Porsche, the KCMG car ahead of him.
Okay, raindrops on start finish.
Like, it's going to start raining very soon. I will leave you in the car because you're familiar. You're doing good.
It's raining, but only a little bit.
Rain all around the track, and it will get harder. It will increase the amount of rain.
Race director Eduardo Freitas is turning weatherman for the benefit and safety of the teams. Here's the battle for the lead. Porsche versus Audi, we've said that many times over the last couple of seasons, and there is a change, and through goes the number one car. Now, this is very important. Oh, brilliant! Puts the Corvette between him and the Audi that was leading, and look at that, streaking away. Look how much time's been lost coming out of turn 16. Loic Duval is struggling out there. He's given up the lead, and now he's going to give up second place. Number two Porsche goes around the outside into the Lake Esses. Well, I wonder if Loic is worried about the conditions or there's something more sinister. Is there a problem with that number eight car? Just easing the Porsche off onto the dirt. No harm, no foul. Rain is getting heavier. Tyre choice now will be absolutely crucial. Two Porsches in again. It's very tight in their pit box. You'd think they'd stagger the pit stops a little bit, wouldn't you? Now, is it going to be full wet? It is. Porsche goes for full wet. They must think it's going to really throw it down. And Audi, do they go for Michelin wet as well? Both cars in there too. Ollie Jarvis about to jump in. Well, they look like the slick intermediates. Philippe Albuquerque here, out on the circuit. He's tiptoeing. You can see that. He's a very experienced driver and he's gone off. There's just no grip there if you're on slick tyres. Drivers and teams have got to work together here, and that's the eight. Out, he's gone off. Ollie Jarvis on his first flying lap. He's off at the first corner. What's happened here? Look in the background. Oh, this is a big one. 180 miles an hour plus, and the front wheels are still spinning. I don't think that's a mistake. I think that's a failure of some sort. Yes, just snaps around. Ollie's a passenger at that point. Ooh, big impact.
Ollie, are you okay?
I'm fine. I braked really early, guys. Something broke. I'm sorry.
Ollie's done a good job to get that car back to the pit lane. Bodywork damage. Yost mechanics go to work.
Sorry, Ollie. You had no chance of that.
I braked really early, really cautious, and the pit went to the floor.
It's all right, dude. Keep your head up. We'll get it fixed up. Get some points. Stay seated.
Aston Martins have been at the head of the GTE Pro Field since we started, and there's where the change came a little bit earlier on. No drama there, and it's the first time the 95's lost the lead other than the pit stop since the start of the race. Richie Stanaway now ahead of Nicky T. Nicky getting very, very squirrely there. Both these cars still on slicks. Oh, that's interesting. That's a piece of Porsche, I think, on that Alpine. Little bit of aerodynamic remodeling. Do you want it back? Do you want it back? No. Okay. Aston Martin's then still first and second in GT Pro, just the other way around. Nicky team just starting to get a little bit slidey again. The back end of the car looking a bit loose. So he's got on the curb there. Oh, he's gone sideways now. Oh, he hasn't got it back. I was about to say I thought he'd got it back, but he hasn't. Yeah, just touched the curb on driver's left. Oh, the wing's gone and the rear diffuser. Look how slippery that grass is. Nicky will get that back, but there's a bit of work to do. Timo Bernhard back in the pit lane in the number one Porsche. Intermediates going on. Porsche have had to do this because of the pace of the number seven car. They're right back in it now. Andrea Lotterer driving brilliantly. Now leads, of course, but also a pit stop. Two Porsches battling in GTE Am for the lead. David Enemeyer Hansen goes long into the stadium section. Wolf Hensler goes through in the KCMG car. Hong Kong leads Abu Dhabi. Dry line appearing as well now. Stefan Sarrazin is driving brilliantly here. A man who is a very accomplished rally driver. He doesn't mind the car moving around. He's using all those skills now. Down the inside, it's very wet there. Can he hold on to it? He can. The 6 Toyota going through into third position. Toyota Gazoo Racing did not expect this kind of result. They've been up against it all week.
In left button and box this lap.
Now, what are Audi going to do tyres-wise? Andrea Lotterer has been taking chunks of time out of the Porsches. That's slicks. Full slicks. Dry weather tyres. Might be a bit of a gamble. Two Brazilians battling here. Bruno Junqueira in the Gibson from Greaves Motorsport with Pipo Durrani behind him. Greaves considering coming to the WEC full-time next year. Mexican colours on the car because there's two Mexican drivers as well as the Brazilian for Greaves this weekend. Oh, now this is very important for the championship and for the race. Second place car getting a drive through. That's going to drop him at least a position. And small mistakes like this can cost a race win. Andre Lotterer in second is pushing really hard and he's catching the leading Porsche.
Okay, Andre, the gap to the leading Porsche is only 23 seconds. You are 3 seconds faster per lap. 3 seconds faster per lap.
Well, not this lap because Lotterer has gone straight on at turn 13. He just gets a little bit close to the manor. Then he's on the curb. That's wet. He's on slick tyres and there's got to be damage. And that's the leader from LMP2. More drama. The G-Drive guys have been robbed of a victory here. What's happened? Oh my goodness! I thought he was on the curb, but it's a brake disc exploded! Reddy Rast could do nothing about that. And this is twice in two races. It was a gearbox at the Nürburgring. Cruel look for the 26 G-Drive racing car. The crowd on the start-finish line know exactly what this means. That's the 43 car going back into the lead. Ricardo Gonzalez's RGR team might yet get that fairy tale win. Predictions of more bad weather before the end of the race. Let's see what Toyota are putting on. Oh, it is those slick intermediates. The little white dash on the side of them. So they must be expecting it to get worse. Last roll of the dice for Audi, second place. They got as close as 23 seconds. They've dropped back after Lotterer went off the circuit. And they're going to... Yeah, they've gone for the intermediates as well. They need rain now if they're going to catch the Porsche. And Timo Bernard doing very nicely. No, not doing very nicely. This happened a moment or two ago. He's almost hit the wall coming out of the stadium. Well, even that slight mistake from Timo a couple of laps ago, 20 seconds he lost. Lotterer still charging, but he's on his last lap, a couple of corners to go, and it's going to be enough tiptoeing through where he almost lost it a couple of laps back. This is an unexpected one, you know. This is not a victory that Porsche thought they'd get.
Winners in Mexico, baby. Winners in Mexico. Awesome. Good job, boys. Cool down, that mate.
Well, a bit mixed, like the weather. I mean, no, absolutely. I'm absolutely happy. I mean, we talked, Mark and Brendan, awesome job. I mean, absolutely happy to bring this victory back for Porsche. And this morning we're chatting about how cool it would be to actually win in Mexico. But yeah, now it was an eventful race and I'm really, really touched because it was a hard work.
It's a hometown win in LMP2.
Yeah, baby. Yeah, baby. Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Felipe Albuquerque has found a Mexican flag. Where was that? In the glove box of the car? pole position and the win. Hollywood could not have scripted this any better. This is huge news for Mexico and for Mexican motorsport.
Very happy, very tense moments at the end with the rain, 2 second gap to second place. I didn't want to watch the TV anymore.
LMP2 podium, ESM in third, championship leaders Alpine in second, but it's the result that everyone here wanted. It was Spa last season, the last time that an Aston Martin team stood on the top step of the podium. A welcome return to form for the British mark.
Really happy for everyone at Aston Martin Racing and Dunlop, you know, getting the first win for them is a real privilege. And yeah, I mean, the rain made it an exciting race because I think if it stayed dry the whole time, it probably wouldn't have been as exciting. So yeah, really enjoyed it and great to get the first win of the season.
Aston Martin 1-3 on the GTE Pro podium. EF Corsa finding a bit of performance and nicking second place. But that result means Darren Turner now leads the World Championship for GT drivers on his own. In GT Am, it's another first-time winner, the 88 Porsche from the UAE. Long, Enemeyer Hansen and Al Kabezi.
We were lucky that it wasn't as hot as yesterday in quali, but yeah, it's a long race, very stressful. So many things going up and down, and we're just happy to see it over and in the winning position.
The first time we've heard the United Arab Emirates national anthem in the WEC. A very happy team indeed. Finally, they get the win. It's beginning to look a little like last year, isn't it? As our winners here in Mexico, the number one Porsche team, look to defend their championship. Didn't get a good Le Mans last year, didn't this? But came on very strongly at the end of the season. Can they defend that championship? An unexpected third position for Toyota Gazoo Racing. Audi will be disappointed with second. Porsche win it. The fairy tale complete in LMP2 with RGR. Aston Martin Racing, they'll be delighted with their win in Pro, as will Abu Dhabi Proton Racing in GTE Am. Action, excitement, an incident on the track at Mexico City, and the atmosphere extraordinary. This may well have been the perfect debut event in the WEC. The checkered flag ended the race, but not the event. A stunning after party, extending the atmosphere late into the evening. For the teams, it's time to take off to Austin.
A place where red, blue, and white are the way.
Thanks, guys. I appreciate it.
A lone star shining bright.
5 minutes more.
Starting with the sun, ending with the moon. Stars and cars.
World Endurance Championship, international event.
Green flag.
The Porsche ahead of you is 5 seconds away.
Stronger.
To start counting down from 6 hours, we're racing at the Circuit of the Americas.
Grandstand.
Oh, hang on a second.
Night and day.
Fantastic.
Well done, everyone. Good job.
Lone Star Le Mans, 6 hours of the Circuit of the Americas, 16th and 17th September. The spirit of Le Mans is coming to Texas.